You are loaded with great potentials. But somehow your life could seem empty and dry. All you need is the Word to come to the place of faith, blessing, and destiny. Your life can be maximized
because the Word of God says so. Because the Word of God says so.
Maximize your life with Dr. Chris Williams.
Do not underestimate the power of atmosphere, power of music, power of lights, power of moods. These things are powerful. Time will not permit us, but that's why I made us read Proverbs chapter 7 throughout. That woman said, I have anointed my beds with myrrh and aloes and cinnamon. I have laid my beds with tapestry. Glory to God. I said, glory to God. There are places you will find yourself. You never were thinking about it. The mood will just come upon you. Such places should be avoided if you don't want to fall. Praise God. Am I communicating? Is somebody following me? Are you sure you are following me? You pick up a young lady every morning to drop her, and then you pick, and after some time you notice that your chemistry towards her is changing. Don't joke with that. You need to make a drastic decision about it. Some of our ladies don't know it, I believe. That's why they join people of the world to wear all kinds of things. Dressings matter. So Bible says, in that Proverbs chapter 7 where we read, it said, and I saw a woman. He didn't say, I saw an harlot. He said, I saw a woman in the attire of an harlot. There are attires that are suggestive. So you are, maybe there's a married man, young lady, you pick her up every time, and then she's wearing skimpy things. And then from here to VI, she's in front of your car, half of her legs are showing. No, see me, praise the Lord. Every day is programming you to do what you don't want to do. Glory to God. If she can't wear long skirts, then let her go and join BRT. Praise God. I actually made up my mind, we'll discuss this, when myself and Pastor Fumi were watching at My View on TVC. One of the days last week, and they were talking about how to know when your husband is beginning to cheat or something. Praise the Lord. And they cited all manners of examples. Is somebody still here or you have gone home? Are you still here or you have gone home? Okay, so dressing, you see that in verse 10. You see the right atmosphere in verse 9. Dark nights. In verse 9, you see in the twilight, in the evening, in the black and dark night. Black and dark night. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. And don't let the devil say just once. Now, what arm does just once? What does he do? You can't be smart. Bible says that the children of darkness in their generation are what? Wiser. She can't be working on you for 2 years, and then she will just allow you to do just once, and then you are gone. If you don't know it now, they rub things on their body. They rub things on their vagina. They know there's no just once anything. No, no just once anything. There are some barbars behind them. Even some pastors, I hear that in Benin, if a young lady was going to Italy in those days, she would go and buy plenty of pants and bras and go and give to some pastors to anoint it with oil. Praise the Lord. To bring better business. Once one Oyibo fool touches it, praise God, he will go home, sack his wife, and that will be where he has his dinner for the rest of his life. He is trapped. You will not be trapped. Oh. Be doing. That's why I said earlier that church people are so naive. Praise the Lord. Somebody says that in the name of Jesus, that cannot affect me. Will you stop that? He that breaketh an egg, the serpent has already beaten him before his confession or no confession. Why did you go and touch what you shouldn't do? Touch, praise the Lord. As you are touching it, every edge has been broken. The edge of the anointing has been broken. The edge of protection has been broken. You are hooked just like every other fool on the street. Glory to God. Is somebody learning something? The next one. Maintain peace in your house. Averting infidelity is what we are discussing for yourself, for your spouse. Let there be peace. Let there be cordiality in your house. Let there be cordiality in your house. Praise the Lord. Do anything to maintain cordiality between you and your spouse. That woman in verse 14 says, I have offered my peace offering. I checked up the Hebrew meaning of that word peace. And it means voluntary sacrifice for alliance or friendship. Voluntary sacrifice for alliance or what? Friendship. What hooked me there is sacrifice for friendship. Somebody say sacrifice for friendship. Make the sacrifice needed for there to be peace in your family. For there to be cordiality in your home. In other words, pay the price. Let me tell somebody, pay the price. Say it one more time. Say it one more time. Pay the price for peace in your family. She said, I have peace offerings with me. This day I have paid my vow. In order to come, you will enjoy peace. If your home is, if you're a clamorous woman, contentious woman, what will first begin to happen is that man will first begin to keep late nights. Praise the Lord. And he's flesh and blood. He's a human being. Before long, he disconnects from you emotionally. But guess what? He begins to connect with somebody else emotionally. At first, maybe for the first 2 years, they are not doing anything physical. Just emotional connection. How are you? Before long, he notices that he enjoys being in the company of this lady. And this lady notices that she also enjoys being in his company. So they want to always be around. And you know, this is where to nip adultery in the bud. Because there's no person who is a young person. We are all adults. You know when the chemistry changes. Praise the Lord. When you feel, is it gish-gish, we call it? You feel gish-gish in the presence of somebody. You know it. You know it. You know it when you are no longer emotionally comfortable in the presence of somebody. So what people do that mess them up is that instead of running away from that, they run towards it or they linger there and enjoy it. And emotions grow. Praise the Lord. Is somebody learning something? So let there be peace. So that you guys will enjoy, will be able to spend time together. Your husband will love coming home. Your wife will love you coming home. She will love being at home. You guys will love being together. Praise the Lord. That woman says, I have made my peace offerings, voluntary sacrifice of friendship. Praise the Lord. Those things that keep causing quarrels between you, leave it. Leave it. If he doesn't want his children to go to school, leave it. And you can't pay their school fee, leave it. Let the children. School is not the heaven and earth. Praise the Lord. Am I communicating? It's not. Let there be peace at home. Take the children to public school. The one that you can afford. Since he has chosen the responsibility. But let there be peace at home. Because before long, you will lose your spouse. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. We can't do number five. Praise the Lord. My time is far spent. I think I will stop here. But that woman said, the good man is not at home. He has taken a bag of money and he has gone on a long what? Journey. I checked one translation says, I think Old Living Bible, he said it will take like 2 weeks before he returns. Something like that. That man was a businessman who will be gone for long periods, ever so often gone. Maybe because he's not happy at home or because he's just a fool. He doesn't know that he should be present physically and emotionally for his spouse. So under his nose, his wife became a harlot. Praise the Lord. Your wife will not become a harlot. What we are saying is not far-fetched too. There are cases in this church of what I'm saying. So it's not far-fetched anything. It can happen to you. Praise the Lord. I do. Okay? And it won't be back for a month. Can you see that Message Bible? And that's how the man will be gone. I've handled cases. The man pushed me into it. I want to burst into laughter when women come around and say it. Can you imagine? My husband hasn't touched me for 2 months. And I like that word, touch. They don't mean like this, so praise the Lord. Our husband has not touched her where it matters. Praise the Lord. Even before physical or whatever touching, genital touching, she means that this man is not ministering to me emotionally. Am I communicating? Very important. He is not ministering to me emotionally. He's not touching my emotions. All kinds that we have heard. All manners. One says, there's nothing I've not done except sleep with another person. I say, so what are the other things you have done? Say, I've used candle. I've used a toothbrush. I've used a toothpaste. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. I'm just using everything. Pastor, help me. Am I communicating? Adele husbands in Eston Church, do your job. Adele wives in Eston Church, do your job. Be available. I'm even first talking about emotional availability. She can have you to talk with, to meet, to spend time with, to be with. We saw Deuteronomy 24 verse 5. A person who has taken a new job should not be saddled with any business or military activities for how many years? So that he may stay at home. Deuteronomy 24 verse 5. Quickly show it to us. So that he may stay at home. So that what will happen? He gets 1 year off simply to be at home, to bring her joy, to bring her fulfillment. Praise the Lord. Many cases of adultery starts with lack of emotional fulfillment. She's just empty. It were better she's a single. Good morning, good morning. That's all she shares with her husband. She's just empty. There's a hollow, there's a vacuum emotionally. And then one small boy. Oh, glory to God, outside. Many, many years a junior at work. Madam, you are... Madam, what's wrong today? Madam, what's happening today? Madam, what's this today? Before you know it, she begins to get emotionally attached to all those sentiments. That's what happened to Potiphar's wife. Remember Potiphar's wife? What did Joseph have that Potiphar didn't have? What was this thick madam looking for inside Potiphar? Inside Joseph? Slave boy. What? Her husband was a general in Pharaoh's army. A man of means. Praise the Lord. But he never was at home. And Joseph, being the nice person that he is, madam, you are looking, that's how he started. Joseph didn't know. Joseph was naive like many church people. Praise the Lord. She didn't know when the handshake passed where the elbow. She didn't know. She was, didn't know. He was just still doing his, before long, madam is dreaming about him, dreaming with him. Praise the Lord. Naive until they drag him one day, bring it out, bring what out. Praise the Lord. Oh, glory to God. You are blessed. No divorces in Enstone Church. I didn't hear your amen. I think we'll continue next week. I thought I'll be able to finish this. Praise the Lord. Put your hands together for.
You are loaded with great potentials, but somehow your life could seem empty and dry. All you need is the Word to come to the place of faith, blessing, and destiny. Your life can be maximized
because the Word of God says so. Because the Word of God says so.
Maximize your life with Dr. Chris Williams.